Men's basketball improved to 17-13, 12-5 in the CAA after a win over George Mason. The win over Mason snapped a 20-game losing streak to the Patriots. So, Coach, in that game, Durrell had 22 first-half points, cooled off a little in the second half. How big was it that other guys on the team showed that they can step up and lead like Marcus Damas and Bilal Dixon did?
Yeah, I mean, that's been huge for us all year. We really had a collective effort, and that was obviously big in the second half. They did a good job of guarding him and really kind of focusing their efforts on stopping him, and so everybody else stepped up. Marcus was huge, Bilal was huge, and Jerome made some big plays. I think we all contributed offensively and defensively to that win down the stretch.
So you guys are coming off that win 85-81. Prior to that, you win 72-71 over Drexel. Earlier in the year, you guys found yourselves on the losing end of a bunch of close games like UMBC and Coppin State, but now you guys are coming out on top. What's changed that the team has been able to come out on top in these close games?
Yeah, well, you know, unfortunately, a lot of those games haven't been all that close until the end. You know, in particular, the Mason game the other night, we gave up a couple of late buckets, kind of made it a little bit more exciting than it had to be. So we continue to have to do a better job of closing out games. But winning close games is important. Obviously, in conference, every game is a battle. So for us to come out on top these last couple has been huge, obviously, for our standing.
It's been a great year for the Tigers. There's no doubting that. Not only do you guys secure the first winning season since the 95-96 season, you also have one of the best turnarounds going in NCAA history. What does the coaching staff credit that turnaround to?
Well, I think the hard work of our players, you know, throughout the offseason, obviously, you know, our guys were committed to having a much better year than they experienced a year ago. And, you know, obviously the influx of some new talent, the transfers that sat out last year, a couple of the freshmen in particular, Jerome and TJ, have stepped up big for us. And so I think all of that and just kind of another year of guys getting stronger, better, working on their games, and like you said, a couple of breaks that we've gotten.
Now you finish up the season at home Saturday at 4 o'clock against Hofstra. What's going to be key for you guys to finish out the season strong and get a W over the Pride?
We're going to have to take care of the basketball. You know, we turned the ball over a bunch, I think almost 20 times down there. We didn't play them too long ago. It was just about 10 days ago. So, we're going to have to be locked in. They're playing really hard. You know, they had a great game last night with Delaware, only lost by 1 point. So they're certainly competing all the way to the end. They've been banged up. They have some injuries. They're going to be missing their starting center for our game Saturday as well. So we're going to have to take care of the basketball. We're going to have to guard the three-point line. They have some dangerous backcourt players, and we're going to have to continue to play to our strengths, which is defending, rebounding, and scoring inside.
So again, the Tigers finish up their season and close out the Towson Center at 4 o'clock this Saturday. Coach Luke Murray, thanks for joining us, and good luck.
Thank you very much.
Hey, Tiger Town, be a part of the uproar and get your Towson basketball tickets today. Get ready to wear your black and gold as head coach Pat Scarry and the Tigers hit the hardwood in their final game at the Towson Center Arena. See the Tigers take on Hofstra in a conference matchup presented by Qdoba, Saturday, March 2nd at 4 p.m. in the Towson Center Arena. Also help support the Tigers in the CAA food drive by donating non-perishable food at the game. For tickets, visit TowsonTigers.com or call 1-855-TIGER. Don't miss out.